No matter what type of thing you sell, no matter what business model you have, basically, if you engage on the internet, you have at least one landing page. So what do I mean under landing page? Well, as the name implies, this is a part of your website which is specifically designed with the intent of people landing there from other traffic sources. So yes, it's nice to have a homepage. It's nice to have blog posts and various other pages on your website. But ultimately, if you want to make the most of an offer, then you should definitely have a dedicated landing page. So if you're running traffic from Google Ads, from Facebook Ads, from any other source where you can get people into your ecosystem, then you should definitely use at least one landing page, but ideally even more types of landing pages for various offers and also various traffic sources. Because as I said, a landing page is laser focused on getting people who land on that page to do something. And usually it's to submit their email address. So most landing pages are or some type of opt-in page, either to get people on your email list or to schedule a free consultation or to subscribe to a webinar or something like that. They usually don't try to sell products upfront, because those are called sales pages. And yes, although they can also work as a landing page, but different rules apply to them. So I'm going to give you 5 quick tips on how you can optimize your landing pages in like 20 minutes. First of all, your offer. This is the most important part of every single landing page. And it's very simple. You should have an offer that people actually want. Without that, you can do anything you want. People are not gonna care and they won't be interested and they'll just bounce away. And then you have wasted a lot of money on low quality traffic, basically. So if you have an offer that people want, and you can test this, you can create surveys, you can talk to people. Don't be afraid to phone a lot of your existing customers or basically anyone else that you consider a representative sample. Just ask them, hey man, what's the number one problem that you're dealing with in this niche? And what's something that can help you fix that problem? So it's basically a measurable solution. And with landing pages, you don't want to create an almighty solution. You just want to give people something which is specific. It gets them one step closer to their ideal situation. And it's easy to consume, because at that point, people don't really trust your brand, don't really trust you. They don't know who you are. And then giving them something which allows them to experience quick wins is a surefire way to move them forward in your funnel. So this is the first tip. Make sure that you have a solid offer. The second tip is, again, goes back to copywriting. So the landing page is a typical page where it's extremely important how well your copy does and how well you're able to capture the pains, fears, hopes, and dreams of your audience. Because ultimately, as we have seen in previous videos, people buy based on emotion and then they justify their decision with logic only later on. So a landing page's job is to warm them up just enough so that they give you a very minimal thing like their email address, so that you get basically permission from them to sell them later on something. So there's also a great book called Permission Marketing, which talks a lot about this. But in 2020 and beyond, always think about asking for permission, not trying to overwhelm people with high pressure sales tactics and creating fake scarcity and everything, because everybody knows that's bullshit. So in today's world, people have a lot of choice. They have a lot of information. So you want to create a conversation with them and you want to be like a good vampire. Okay, invite yourself into their house, and then you have permission to basically move forward with whatever you want to do. So this is the second tip. The third tip is UX. Nowadays, you know, there are a lot of beautiful websites, and the current trend is for landing pages to have a lot of white space, to not be overwhelming with text, to have some nice visuals, nice transitions and everything, so that everything seems like, let's say, closely similar to how an Apple web page looks like, because this creates a breathing room for people. This creates a sense of luxury. This creates something that seems desirable. They don't know exactly why that is, but they just feel like it's something that they should want. And this is your end goal here. This is what you should be aiming at, to create feelings in people, create emotions, because they make decisions based on that. So a good UX, and this stands for user experience, ensures that people won't just skip your landing page and immediately bounce, but they will actually give it more consideration. And don't be fooled, you only have a limited time to get the attention of people. You only have 1, 2, 3, maximum 4 seconds, but I don't think that you have that much time. Just a few seconds. If you don't do it with good copy, good UX, and an immediate feeling that you're generating in people, then they will bounce away and you lose them. Okay, the fourth tip is that you should definitely highlight what people should expect after they complete the action that you want them to take on the landing page. So don't be afraid to mention next steps. Don't be afraid to explain what happens when they subscribe, if they try a free trial or submit a consultation or something like that. Because people are weary. There's a lot of scammers out there, and they just don't know what happens. They don't want to get spammed by some random guy on the internet. So make sure to build trust and to somehow show what happens next. And the fifth tip I have for you is to build more desire for whatever you are trying to get them on. So if you want them to download your ebook or your freebie, then don't be afraid to give them a few bullets of what they can expect with outcomes, with benefits. After you go through this 11-page ebook, you'll be able to point A, point B, point C, point D. So don't be afraid to use this. This is basically mandatory in copywriting. And even if you think that you write more than there's necessary, just remember that most people won't read every single line of your copy, but you never know what's the element that will connect with them and will make them pull the trigger. So you never know this. That's also why it's important to have a lot of facts and bullets in other parts of your sales pages, for example, as well, because you never know what connects with your audience. And a quick bonus tip, how long should your copy be? It totally depends, as long as it needs to be to convey the idea that you want. So if your offer is super simple, if it's like 5 foolproof vegan recipes, then it doesn't have to be long. But if you're selling like a meditation audio, then you'll probably have to explain it in a little bit more detail so that people subscribe to the free version of it or something. So with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this. Leave a comment below as always. Let me know the number one tip that you found helpful here. And as always, see you tomorrow with the next one. Stay safe.